when we measure an optical link, we also have a look at the bit error rate. But what does it actually measure, and more importantly, how do we qualify the result? If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. To understand the bit error rate, let's first talk about what an error is. In this setup, we've got a transmitter, and that transmitter will transmit a sequence of bits, in this case 8. And the receiver will receive those bits. But as you can see here, highlighted in red, that one bit is different to what was originally transmitted, meaning that is one error. Now, the bit error rate is the number of errors in relation to the total number of transmitted bits. So in other words, if we have 100 errors out of a million transmitted bits, that means we will have a bit error rate of 0.0001, or put differently, a bit error rate of 10 to the negative 4. In optical networks, we target for, well, of course, depending a little bit on the type of transceiver standard, and so let's say after forward error correction, we target a bit error rate of equals or less 10 to the negative 12. And that means equals or less one error per 1 trillion bits. Now, since we're talking about the number or sequence of bits, obviously the bit rate also has an impact. Now, let's stick to that bit error rate of 10 to the negative 12. If we're measuring a 1 gigabit signal with this bit error rate, what that means is we're measuring 0.06 errors per minute, or put differently, we will measure roughly one error every 15 minutes. Whereas for a 100 gigabit signal, we are measuring 6 errors per minute. So there's a big difference, and how can we make sure that this 100 gigabit, 1 gigabit measurement is as reliable as the 100 gigabit measurement? And that is then where the so-called confidence level comes into play. And the confidence level is basically a statistical value as to how reliable the measurement is. Now, once again, sticking to that target bit error rate of 10 to the negative 12, and if we want to achieve a 90% confidence level, it hasn't got anything to do with time. It has to do with the number of bits, so the bit sequence. And for the 90%, we need to measure a sequence of 2.3 times 10 to the 12th bits. So in other words, we need to measure 2.3 trillion bits, so a sequence of 2.3 trillion bits, to achieve a confidence level of 90%. If we, on the other hand, want to achieve a confidence level of 99.9%, we need to measure a sequence of 6.9 trillion bits. So if we take all of those things together, so we've got the target bit error rate, we've got the confidence level, and we've got the bit rate of the data, that will directly translate into telling us how long a measurement has to be. So if we then go to the 90% confidence level, 10 to the negative 12 bit error rate, target rate, that means that a 1 gigabit signal will have to be measured for 38.5 minutes until we achieve that confidence level. So almost 40 minutes, whereas a 400 gigabit signal, we will achieve that confidence level after only 5.8 seconds. If we go all the way up to the 99.9 confidence level, the 1 gigabit signal will have to be measured for almost 2 hours, whereas the 400 gigabit signal achieves the confidence level of 99.9 after only 17.3 seconds. So you can see there's a huge difference between 1 gig and 400 gig. So maybe it's an idea to upgrade your system to a higher data rate, because that will save you a lot of time. No, just kidding. So I hope you enjoyed this video and that you learned something. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel so you get your regular dose of brain snack. Until next time, bye-bye.